hard time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh,
might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, Lawrence put on Christ, in the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory.
Death, nor life, nor angels, nor prince, nothing that exists, Let him still to come, need not any power or height or depth, not any created things can ever come between us and the love of God, made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Let's all stand for the proclamation of the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 praise the Lord. Alleluia, 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 praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, alleluia, praise the Lord, alleluia, praise the Lord, alleluia, praise the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Seeing the crowds, Jesus went up the hill. And then he sat down and was joined by his disciples. And then he began to speak. This is what he taught them. How happy are the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle, they shall have the earth for their heritage. Happy those who mourn, they shall be comforted. Happy those who hunger and thirst for what is right, they shall be satisfied. Happy the merciful, they shall have mercy shown them. Happy the pure in heart, they shall see God. Happy the peacemakers, they shall be called sons of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of right, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel, the good news of the Lord. Please be seated. Our second reading today from Romans reminds us that there is nothing on the face of the earth that can come between us and the love that God has for us, that love which is made visible in Jesus Christ. Nothing we can do, nothing we can think of, nothing at all can take that love that God has for us away. But you see, the trouble is, do we believe that? Do we believe that God's love for us is so strong that absolutely nothing can separate us from the love of God which is made visible in Jesus Christ? You know, oftentimes, you know, we hear things, oftentimes we repeat things, but do we believe what we hear? I'm sure we've heard this reading over and over and over and over and over again, and some of us may be able to repeat it word for word, but do we actually believe what the scripture is saying to us? You know, and that is part of our problem. That is part of our issue. We hear what the scripture is saying, but we do not accept what God is saying to us. God said in another passage, I will never leave you orphan. I know you. Before you were born, I consecrated you. But do we believe that? And that is the issue why, you know, we see lots of things happening. We see, if I know that my God loves me beyond all understanding, then I have nothing to worry about because I know my every need will be supplied. Not true? Yes. I know that my every need would be supplied. I know everything that I would ever desire, once it is for my good, God will provide for me.
And so too, we are called to love the people around us with that same love that God has for us. And if we are able to love the people around us with that same love that God has for us, then we're good to go. We're good to go. You know, but we like to become judgmental. Oh, this person is not living according to what God asked them, so I keeping them at arm's length. Oh, this person is this, so I'm keeping them at arm's length. We are all made in the image and likeness of God with the dignity of a human being. That's what it is. And God, you know, I think it's Tennyson John who sings, God did not put you to watch me. Yes, God didn't put us to watch anybody, what kind of life they are living. What God put us on the face of the earth to do is to love one another as I have loved you. That's what it is. To love one another as I have loved you. Have we loved one another unconditionally? And you know, we need to start doing a lot of introspection, because you know, we go around, you know, we talk a lot. We don't mind our own businesses, and we are so preoccupied with everything everybody else is doing except our own. But we have a job to do. We have to love our neighbors as ourselves without counting the cost. Without counting the cost. Just this week I was speaking to some people, you know, from the church, and I was saying, you know, we were preparing, we got some food items, and we were preparing, you know, because we want to give it to them next week. And you know, I said to the people, what happens thereafter? After we've handed those packages to the people we call poor, what happens thereafter? I say, who visits them on a regular basis? Who goes to pray for them? Who goes to check on them? And everybody went quiet. And I said, you know what? I am part of it as well, because I've been in the parish for 3 years. But the parish of Our Lady of the Assumption, they have failed these people. And people open their mouths and open their eyes. But it's true. It's true. Because if we had loved these people as we love ourselves, we will not remember that they exist. Only when we have a pack of rice and some milk and some soy and some cornmeal to give them. No, we would remember that they are there every day. It is because we have not loved these people. And giving them a parcel of food doesn't mean that we love them anyway. Because many of us, we say, oh, mwebai mensa apache mahi. Mable Pearson Savon who had 24 moon long at this and she may have died. But it's true. It's true. It has happened to me. Somebody brings something in the presbytery. Father, I don't want nobody to know, you know. Me come and moon ask me to ask she may have. And tell me nearby, but we do me think I may nearby now. You know, how serious are we, you know, about loving, about doing the will of God? And it's the will of God that is going to take us into heaven. It is for those of us who believe that there is life after death, it is doing the will of God that will take us yonder. It is doing the will of God that will assure us of a place in heaven, wherever that may be. But we are called to love others. We are called to love others as we have loved ourselves. And I'm hoping that, you know, when we go back to some level of normality, that the members of this parish community can see the need to go and visit people, not only when they have a parcel of food to drop for them or to ask them to come for it, but there be a certain level of communion, a certain level of knowing what happened to these people. a certain level of visitation, a certain level of connection with these people, or else we are failing them. Because we are called to be the expression of God's love on the face of the earth. That's what it is. We are called to be the expression of God's love on the face of the earth. And if we are not being the expression of God's love on the face of the earth, then crap will smoke our pipes. During this continued lockdown, we are returning back to normal. How have I loved my neighbor in this period? How have I reached out to my neighbor in this period? And you know, the problem is, most of us, we call ourselves Christians. Most of us, we call ourselves Christians. But the problem is, when we come and we are challenged by the preaching, we say the priest is throwing words at us because we don't want to change our lives. We don't want to change our lives. We are called, we are here on the face of the earth to be the expression of God's love. And if we are not being the expression of God's love to our brothers and sisters, no matter creed, color, race, religion, we have a problem. We have a problem because we are all serving the same God. It's one God that we are serving. So if you don't speak to this person because you are with Jehovah, you are with Pentecost, you are with Messiah, you have a serious problem. You don't belong here either. Because the love of God knows no boundaries. The love of God knows no boundaries. So I want to encourage us this afternoon as we continue to look at ourselves and to look at how much have I loved my neighbor? How much have I loved that person who gossips about me? How much have I loved that person who puts fire behind the house every time I open close on the line? How much have I loved that person who carries words on me to my boss and those kind of things? We do not have a choice but to love unconditionally. And if we endeavor to love unconditionally, our families, our community of Sufre and St. Lucia by extension would be a better place. I want to invite all of us to be men and women who's passionate about loving our brothers, loving the people who we encounter on a daily basis. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Father, raise his son from the dead. With confidence, he asks him to save all his people, living and dead. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. For Lawrence, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For our brother who entered the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For our brother, for our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of our brother Lawrence, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Precious Lord, take my hands, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the land. Take my hands, precious Lord, lead me on. When my world is so down, and my race there is run, let me see by the light thou art shown. Thy mercy is so bright, where the love is the light. Take my hand, precious soul, lead me on.
At this time we'll have the signing of the register. We invite Mr. Michael Nicholas, Ms. Anthony Dennis, Ms. Delma Nicholas, and Ms. Catherine Stanislas to please come up. And again, I invite you to join me in the hymn, Wings of a Dove.
While the book of your life was open, my mother books open, which would record of what they had done in their lives, by which the dead were judged. The sea gave up of all the dead who were in death and hate were empty. Of the dead that were living, and everyone were judged according to the way in which he had been. Then death and hate were poured into the burning lake. This burning lake is the second death. Anybody whose name could not be found written in the book of life was thrown into the burning lake. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven, the first earth had disappeared now, and there was no longer any sea. The word of the Lord.
We brought on our side who can be against us. Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus, though he not only died for us, he rose from the dead and there are God's right hand. He stands and pleads for us. Nothing therefore can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried or being persecuted or lacking food or clothes or being threatened or even attacked, these are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loves us. For I am certain of this, neither death nor life nor angels nor prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or might or death, not any created things can ever come between us and the love of God made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
But wasn't for God's alone.
the persons who are there, the remains of the persons who are there, are loved ones of persons from our community. And I think the cemetery should be in a presentable way at all times. So whatever we collect here, that is what it is going to be. Thank you. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Before we move our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Lawrence, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Lawrence again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Join the blessing and join in the hymn because he lives. God sent his Son.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to help him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercy, we commend our brother, Lawrence, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, we will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Lawrence in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lawrence, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest.
Our final hymn before we leave, softly and tenderly. Again, brothers and sisters, we remind that when you get to the entrance, please observe social distancing. Do not crowd up upon each other.
In peace, let's take our brother to his final resting.
No, no, no. I never. Come on, man, sing it down for all gold. Right about now, Dashin is supposed to be singing the final song for all gold.
You understand it. Every single thing I try to do. I love you for the way you never doubt me. God most of all, I love you, cause you live. No matter what the world may say about you, I know your love will always be. I love you for 100,000 miles. No matter what the world may say about you, I know your love will always see me through, see me through. I love you for 100,000 reasons. But most of all, I love you, cause you.
Have to control my day.
But most of all, I love you, cause you.
Il vient de nez. Vas-y, viens de nez. Eh bien, quand il est là, au point de temps, ça arrive à y voir.
Merci. Young people without a thing, see some birds spread their wings, settle down, just what they need, living on love. You don't care about what's inside, you just like the way it's mine. It takes more marble in there, living on love. Living on love, by it on time, without somebody not being able to die. Like an old-fashioned storybook run, living on love. It's so simple, that's what you're thinking. Love can walk too far without blinking. It doesn't take much when you get enough. Living on love. La 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 la. Two old people without resting. Children gone, feel this thing. Start to sadness, friends out swing. Living on love. The darkest of highways, gold rings in my head, one smell of calidos rising up to the air. Overhead in a distance, I'm gonna hear my red light. My hands will be in my eyes to dream. It was a night. like it stands in the doorway. I wrote a mission there. And I was thinking to myself, this could be heaven or this could be hell. You are out of the candle, and she showed me the way. There were voices from the corridor. I thought I heard them say, welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place.
Such a lovely place.
Such a lovely place. When you're running in the Hotel California. Any time of the year. Any time of the year, you can find Joshim here. This has the funny twist up. Jagamos in his veins. You have lots of pretty, pretty boys. Keep our friends. See the dogs in the courtyard. Such a lovely place, such a lovely place, such a lovely place. Many are running in your California. What a night of Christ, what a night of Christ, bring your eyes.